Hi friends, today I am going to share with you a community managed microhydel power project. I am going to open the video. So this is the microhydel project. This is the alternator or generator. This generator is coupled with this turbine through belt drive. This is the safety net to avoid any hazards. This is the turbine and this is the shaft bearing, and this is also a safety net to avoid any damage to human. So I want to check the whether there is any vibration in the shaft. So when come here, and this the adjust, through this adjust we control the guide vane. Through this guide vane the flow of water is regulated or controlled as per demand. Yes, this is the control panel. There are indicators showing the light. And this is the main valve, water regulating gate. This is a pulley. Water comes through this pipe. The water is regulated through this gate wall by the operator, and a last water enters into this casing. This is the turbine. The water enters into the turbine and rotates the turbine. There is a runner inside this casing. When the water strikes with the blades of the runner starts to rotate, and it rotates the pulley. This pulley is connected with the generator through the belts. These are the belts over the pulley. The voltage, frequency, and this another panel. Yeah, here inside the panel, this is a kilowatt hour meter. At this time, it is not working. So this MHP is supplying the total capacity of this project is 108 kilowatt, and it is supplying electricity to more than 180 households of the village. The people of the village use their electrical and electronics appliances through this electricity. They use heaters for heating and cooking, butter churners, irons, fans and everything through this electricity. This is the locally manufactured turbine. Here you can see the dimensions. So this is another turbine. I was told that this turbine doesn't work in winter season. It needs more quantity of water. So in winter season there is a less amount of water, and the community replaced the small turbine with this big one. In summer season, when the water increases in the nala, they will use this turbine. There are two operators, one for day and one for night. The plant runs 24 hours of the day. Now this is the outer side of the powerhouse. Snow falling, and clean weather. I just come back. You can see the operators installed the dish, and they have the TV inside their operator room with electricity heaters. Very nice room. And since in winter season you can watch, there is a sever cold. so they use electrical heater for heating. So this is a penstock pipe. Water comes through this pipe from the tank. Here is the tank, water tank, or four bay, you can say four bay. It was also told me that once this a big stone came from the upper side and hit the wall of the powerhouse, the operators flew away to save their lives. So very nice view with clean and green blue sky. This water coming out after hitting the turbine. You have ice, sever cold, temperature may be minus 8 to 10 degree. Just see here, this is the snow, white snow. The community has its own management system to operate and manage all the activities regarding this project. There is no other electricity, so they have to manage the system. Thank you very much for watching my video clip.